And then we come up with KSAs for each of these, and then we turn around, group them together, we turn them into ELOs, and sometimes they're the same, sometimes they're not, whatever. So when we take it into our learning environment, we have TLOs, which is the end state, and then we have ELOs, which are the building blocks to get to this. So if I'm your student, I have to convince you that I can do these four things. And if I can convince you that, whatever means possible when you observe and measure me, whether it's through actual observation with my eyeballs or observation through me looking at a document, like an essay that I wrote, and then you grade it with a checklist and a rubric, checking it, see I hit all the components, plus to what degree of quality they're right, things like that. That's how I would prove to you that I can do whatever, and then you let me leave with a certificate. So that's typically, is that everyone's understanding?
Yep.
Okay, so having said that, how do we do it the other way?
Randy, you're not completely understanding that.
Okay, and I know you do. I'm just trying to, for the sake of us being on the same sheet of music, because hell, I think I'm confused. So on the other side, this is my understanding, and maybe I'm wrong. So on the other side of it, it's you have the same three-tiered approach, I think. You have an overall objective.
Learning outcome.
So a learning outcome.
Wait a minute now. You have a program objective.
Yes.
You have a program outcome, and you have a learning outcome.
Okay, let's just put it on.
Then you have educational objectives.
Okay,
so which one are we talking about now?
Learning outcome. The program outcome is the whole, it's not assessed, is the whole
to developing a
school.
Yeah.
Of course.
But Marcos, when you say program, you're translating as program of instruction, right? Not as in...
And like I used the example yesterday, to us, for the corporal's course, which is now called corporal school, there is a program outcome for the whole school.
Okay. Right.
Same thing for the
service
course.
Yeah. So let's call it corporal's course. So we're working on the corporal's
purpose and scope.
Okay. So corporal's course is a program of instruction, right? Doesn't matter if we use learning outcomes or tasks, it's a program of instruction. Do we all agree?
No.
Yes.
We don't?
They still have POIs.
They have POIs, but you're still comparing an apple to an orange.
Well,
comparing
I'm
a
trying
POI
to
a task. And to me, that is not. Now, if you said a corporal to a maintenance chief, that's you're comparing apples and apples.
Okay. May I?
Yeah.
At the corporal's course, they teach them things that are task oriented, that require performance steps.
Yeah, but
that's
down the road a little bit.
Okay, sure.
Where does your initial. How do you know what you need to teach that corporal in the first place?
In the learning outcomes. Because they're.
But where do those learning outcomes come from?
We have to look at, okay, we look at the program outcome and the overall.
So then you do a task analysis, right?
Yes.
And you split it up into job tasks.
Yes.
And then you take each one of those job tasks and you turn it into. Or you, where do you go? Where do you go then?
Okay, I'll try to make it easier. At EPME, I am in charge of the leadership, administration, and communication. So we have a program outcome. We know we want these corporals to be ethical leaders and be able to write and communicate effectively. And that is not the program outcome, but what's going to be in there. Then we have these five learning areas: leadership, communication, administration, joint ops, and warfighting. Every single one of those areas is going to have either one learning outcome or two learning outcomes. You know, it all depends on how much information is going to be in there. And I want to use the example of leadership. We have two learning outcomes in there. One of the learning outcomes is, I should have brought it, but it has to do with MCRP 6-11. And if we didn't use by the end of this course, but we said, you know, that what things they need to learn in order to achieve or get all the information in leadership. Then we break it down in that learning outcome into educational objectives, which is going to be every class. You know, we have managed career progression, we have sustaining the transformation. The corporal being the keeper of tradition. So these are three different classes, three different educational objectives. We have to do a learning analysis for every single one of those classes, every single one of those educational objectives, and we come up with instructional components, which is actually going to be every talking point on that class. So we create an outline. We have the learning outcome, we have the educational objective, and we have all the instructional components that they need to learn in order to achieve, you know, to learn everything that they need on that for that educational objective. Then those educational objectives, those 3-4 classes, you know, everything that they need to know in order to learn everything that, you know, that it's on that learning outcome, that encompasses that learning outcome. When they get assessed, they get assessed for that learning outcome. It doesn't mean that you cannot assess them, you know, on every educational objective by practical application, case studies. You know, they still get assessed, but the overall grade that they're going to get is for that learning outcome.
So, can you remember off the top of your head just one example of a learning outcome that you guys use?
Managed career progression.
How do you measure that?
And again,
they're on that.
We're measuring that learning outcome.
Put up there.
We're measuring the learning outcome. You know, we're not measuring that educational objective. We can measure it by practical applications again, or case studies.
So, I'm sorry, managed career progression.
Right.
That's a task, or that's an outcome.
It's an educational objective. It's a class.
So then, by the end of this course. This person will manage their career progression?
Well, what they have to do is they have to manage the career progression of their subordinates. But at the end of the course, they have to submit a plan for one of their subordinates on how to manage their you know, career progression.
That you create with a rubric. Mm-hmm.
So is the learning outcome not then create a career progression plan for a...
That's not the learning outcome.
Okay, can I take a stab at this real quick? Is this what it is? So our ELOs are your components.
Correct.
Yes.
And then
your TLOs is your EO. Our TLOs is your EO.
Yes.
Right.
Yes.
And then our master lesson follows your learning.
Yes. 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 That's, but the point is that these are hybrids. That's what I said yesterday. We're not talking about absolute outcomes and absolute... We're creating hybrids here. We're creating something new and different.
If we were T3S in a CCRB, we would be working on training. You know, basically, okay, going back and forth between a learning analysis as we know it for training and new programs. But that's not what we're here to do.
Absolutely. So if our end state is to, because can we agree that this becomes this?
Yes. Yes.
Okay. So that means we're really building these.
We do not have condition and standard. They do not. And when I said earlier about, you know, having both TNR events and learning outcomes, we do not combine them as far as like TNR events and learning outcomes in the same class.